Hey guys, welcome back to the farm. Hope you enjoyed the last video of the Kioti doing some snow removal. That was a lot of fun and so much easier than shoveling. Only problem I had was lost my microphone. So sorry if the sound quality on this isn't the best, just using the camera there. But today, you're not gonna believe it, but the Kioti is going back in the shop tomorrow. The air conditioner still is not fixed. This will be the third time in for that. One of the vents inside broke. Not sure if that was me or it, whatever. And then I was greasing up the backhoe and one of the Zerk fittings popped out as I was pulling off the grease gun. Doesn't look like it was in all the way, and it just stripped the threads clean. So they're gonna fix that for me. So before that happens, I wanna finish cleaning the area in front of the logs. So I can make some more firewood over here for the next couple days. I also need to clear to the backhoe, get that back on the tractor and ready to go. And then also I want to make a path into the backyard. So I'm gonna be tapping the maple tree soon, hopefully. So I don't wanna be going through a bunch of snow for that. Not sure when all this is gonna melt. Hopefully this week, but you never know. So let's get going. There, so I wouldn't run into it. Thank you. So that should free the backhoe, but before I get that hooked up, I'm gonna go clear a path in the back, so let's have some fun with that. Well, I'd say that worked pretty good. Got a path cleared to all the maples just in case this decides to hang around for a week or two. Hopefully it doesn't. It's supposed to warm up, but you never know. So there we go. Let's go get the backhoe on. So again, this was just a clear path for me to walk down in case I decide to tap the trees this week, just in case the snow takes a long time to melt. So that'll come in pretty handy. Last year during maple season, it snowed a bunch and I was pretty much walking through a foot of snow, which was not fun. It's a long way up to the house from back there, especially carrying 5-gallon buckets. So we're gonna do a little different this year, plan ahead. I tell you what, this coyote just plows through everything. I have not had any problems with it not being able to move in the snow, so quite impressed.
So the nice thing is there's a little window on the tractor where I can look straight down. So I'm just lining up that plate with the rails. Let me show you.
So this window here, I can look straight down and then get this plate lined up with the holder there. So now I'm gonna hook up the hydraulics and lift it up and see if I can get it level and on there.
Go down a hair in the front.
So I'm adjusting the boom and then we go up a hair in the back here.
Here. I have the tractor off while doing this so I don't accidentally bump something. Turning around, that'd be bad. Thank you. in place. Last thing to do is hook the hydraulic line up and out of the way.
You can't see it because it's covered in snow and grease, but right here on the pad is where the zerk fitting popped out, so that's what they need to fix.
Well guys, another video done, and unfortunately we're going to be without the tractor for a bit. The way they've been working, no idea when they're going to come back, so that's why we went ahead and cleared the snow in the back to get ready to tap the maple trees. So next videos we'll either be doing that, might still be a little early, or cutting some firewood, but not going to do much else until all the snow is gone. So as usual, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. We really appreciate it. Don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button and turn on those notifications to get updates when we post future videos. And if you're a returning subscriber, thanks for coming back and supporting the channel. We really appreciate it. And we'll see you all next time on the farm.